This is a continuation of the videos discussing the Konica Minolta print controllers. This video will specifically use the IC-605 on the AccurioPress model. The same information is applicable to the black and white presses and some of the older models of Konica Minolta presses as well. In this module, we're going to talk about the forms overlay. You will see that I've got a Word document opened up here. It just has several pages of black text. And on page number one, I've got a pretty good sized blank area here to allow for the overprinting of the letterhead graphic for my document. I'm going to start by opening up the print driver properties. In the print driver properties, I'm going to use the blue arrows to arrow over so that I've got access to my forms. When I get to the form section of the print driver, you can see that the top button here is for acquire form data. Green checkbox next to it just means that it has acquired the stored form data on the machine. Next, I've got a list of my forms. In this drop-down, you'll see that although I have several forms populated on the machine, they are all grayed out and I am not able to choose any of those. If I hover my mouse over it for a second, it will tell me that this is a letter-sized document with three pages stored at 1200 dpi as a color image with a fixed screen. If I come back then and look at my imaging tab, we'll see that my current resolution of my driver is set for 600 dpi. That's the main reason why I can't see it. One of the other things that it pointed to was that I was using a fixed screen on that document. I've got this set to a fixed screen, and this driver is currently set for color mode. So if I change this to 1200 dpi, come back into my forms button, we'll see that I'm now able to select several of the forms that are stored here. This last form on the list, if you look at the bottom of its flyout window, it says that it was stored with a custom screen. In order to be able to use that form, I would have to also select a custom screen on my imaging tab. To start with, I'm going to select company letterhead 3-page. You'll see that it comes up with a diagram here of which pages in my form are going to be assigned to which pages within my document. And then on the right-hand side, I've got a preview that shows my letterhead, the second page of my letterhead with a faded logo, and the third page of my letterhead, which is just a full color logo. On this particular document, I had six pages in my Word document, so I would have the first page of the letterhead on page one of the document, second sheet in the letterhead with the faded logo would go on to page number two of my document, and this full color logo would go on to page three. The following three pages would be blank. That is probably not what I would want for this document. I do have some options. I could come back to select just a single page and say I wanted my letterhead, and I can have it repeated so that that letterhead would go onto every page. If this was a one-page document or my document was formatted out so that it would be appropriate to have my letterhead logo at the top of each page, that would be fine, but in this case that is probably not going to work because I've got text up in the top areas of these other pages. If I select just once, it will put a letterhead on the front sheet and the rest of the sheets will be blank. In many cases that may be acceptable for what you are trying to do. Another option that I've got is to turn my form off and come to the lower section. And I can double click here, say that I would like to use my letterhead, and I would like to have my full letterhead put on page one. I can double click again and say that I would like to use the middle pages, which is the faded logo. It will show you here what an image of that page is. I will now put that behind pages 2 through 5. And I can come in now on my back page and say that I would use my back page on number 6. So if I were to go from here, I'm going to come over to my workflow tab and I'm going to say that I would like to hold this document. In your case, you may not need to hold it. I'm going to hold it so that I can show you what that document is going to look like without having to print those documents out. Now I have come over to the Accurio Print Manager, and in this case I am looking at this document at the top of my list, which is the Word document that I just sent with my overlay. And you can see on page number 1 of 6, I've got my first page letterhead. Pages 2 through 5 have the faded logo in the background of these images. And page number 6 just has my full company logo at the back. Another option that I could use for this, in the event that I did not want that last page to have the logo on it, I wanted to add that logo onto a back page by itself, or perhaps I had terms and conditions I would like to add to a print job at the end of it, I can come back into my print driver settings. Once again, coming back to my Forms tab. And in this case, I will select that last page and I will turn it off. And then I will come down below that and on Append, I can say I would like to append a back page onto that document. This would let me, as I said, add a terms and conditions to the back of a contract, or if I had a back cover that I wanted to create on there, or if I wanted to put a back sheet on my document, I could use that. There's also one for Prepend. So if I had something I wanted to attach to the front of the document, I can do that as well. Now I'm going to talk about storing a form. In this case, I've got a PDF of my document. I'm just going to print this and store it as a form. In this case, I'm going to go to the Imaging tab. You can see that I've got a 600 dpi resolution chosen. On Forms, you'll see that I have nothing selected on this form. I do not use anything on the Forms tab to actually store form data. Instead, I come to the Workflow tab, and you can see that my output method is going to be form, and I have added a file name here that says this is letterhead at 600 dpi, and I will print that document to the machine. Now if I come back into my Word document and I go to print it again, if I come back to my Forms button and I look at my list of forms, you'll see that I have my letterhead at 600 dpi. It's grayed out because I need to come back into my Imaging tab and set my document to print at 600 dpi. Once I have it set for 600 dpi, I could choose letterhead to print at 600 dpi, and I would be able to print this document. So the last thing that we need to talk about here is how to get rid of a document that has been stored as a form that I no longer need as a form. So I've got that document selected up here as letterhead at 600 dpi, and you'll see at the bottom right, I've got a password box. The default password is going to be password. That can be changed on the machine, but the default is password. And then I can hit the clear form button. When I hit the clear form button, I come back up and I see that my letterhead at 600 dpi has been cleared from the screen. So I can add forms, delete forms, and use forms.